Yeah, good morning. The title of my presentation here is Accuracy Analysis of Sentinel-2A and Landsat-A Operational Land Imager Satellite Data Sets over Kano State, Nigeria, using Vegetation Spectral Indices. My name is Isiye Olalekan. I have my co-presenters, Akomola Fe and Ikwezi, all from the Department of Geomatics, Ahmadu Bello University, Zaria, Nigeria. Outline of my presentation, introduction, materials, method, you have the results, and just a quick conclusion. Land use mapping is a vital topic in study of surface ecophysics together with vegetation, soil, building, water, and other surface elements. Amongst them, vegetation is the most stable to identifying surface climate change. Presently, remote sensing in an applied approach for vegetation appraisal by using vegetation variables, which varies vigorously in time and space. The foremost role of environmental remote sensing to land resource management is its prospects to mapping vegetation resources and to observe changes over prolonged epochs. Vegetation monitoring remains a fundamental focus within the science and practice of remote sensing, and however, the choice or accuracy of remote sensing sensors used in vegetation monitoring remains of great importance. In this study, we try to explore the we tried to explore the spatial temporal changes between two remote sensing sensors, that is the Landsat-8 operational imager and the Sentinel-2 over Minjibil local government area in Kano State. Four vegetative indices were considered. This is the normalized vegetation index, leaf area index, the green chlorophyll index, moisture index for the period of 2015 to 19. As you can see, this is the study area. We have Kano. This is Kano State here. This is the map of Nigeria. We have Kano State. You can see the Minjibil local government. So the vegetation of Kano State is a semi-arid savanna zone. The zone has been described as the zone that provides the opportunity for optimal human attainment. These are the data types, as you can see here. Two data types, as earlier described, the Landsat-8 and the Sentinel-2. Landsat-8 at 30 meter resolution and the Sentinel-2 at 10 meter resolution. The Landsat data was gotten from the Explorer, that is through the USGS, and we got the Sentinel-2 from the Copernicus. So this table gives a summary of the data set for the 3-year period, that's 2015, 17, 2019, the path row, the cloud cover, and the dates at which the different satellite images were. So as part of the pre-image processing, the portion of which occurs the Minjibil local government was subsetted from each of the larger screens using ArcGIS software. Geometric and radiometric corrections were performed on them for the purpose of auto-rectification. The Sentinel-2A image were obtained as partial resolution of 10, while that of Landsat was at 30, but we had to match up the two data sets to be at the same spatial scale. So during the data layer scale, all bands of the sensors data, excluding the thermal band, were considered for layers taken. The nature of the different bands had to be considered to make a decision as to which three bands combination would be the most helpful for classification and visual interpretation. Thus, the first color composites was employed in this. So the image classification and accuracy, a supervised classification was performed of first color composition, that is band 5, 4, and 3 for Landsat. Then we had band 843 for Sentinel-2 into the following land use and land cover classes. We had light vegetation, build-up area, dense vegetation, water body, bare surface, and using the Anderson 1976 classification. So the accuracy assessment was done by determining a confusion matrix. This finds the relationship between the mapped class label and that observed on the ground or reference data for sample of cases at specific location. The overall accuracy can be determined by dividing the number of correctly classified pixels by the total number of reference pixels. So overall accuracy is considered as the most suitable method for calculating accuracy assessment. The Kappa coefficient of agreement was used to improve the overall this table shows just the how the different vegetative indices were calculated. So this is the image classification accuracy report we have. This is the image classification between 2015 to 2019 for Landsat 8, and we have for Sentinel. This table 3 and 4 here shows us the classification in terms of the area size between the Sentinel-2A and the Landsat-A for the different years period. Then we have the classification accuracy also between the same period. We have the producer accuracy and the user accuracy comparison between two of the both of them, and they were perfect agreement. But the results also, we still have this is the NDVI value for Landsat 8 and Sentinel 2 over the same period. These are just the plots. So this shows the various statistics, low value, high value, mean values between the two. We also have the same for the grain chlorophyll index, also for the moisture in leaf area index. So these are the different statistics as it applies to each of the different vegetative. Also, a correlation analysis of Sentinel 8 and Sentinel 2A derived vegetative index was performed. So, as we can see in the table here for the NDVI, DSI, MSI, and the LAI for the different years, we could see the coefficient of determination and the coefficient of coefficients. So, this shows the different statistics, though we can observe not too strong relationship between the two as presented. These are just some of the scattered plots between the two images and concern. This is for the NDVI, we have for the GSI, also we have for the MSI, and for the leaf area. So in this study, multispectral analysis was performed on two different satellite sensors, Sentinel-2A and the Landsat A for the Minjibir local government. Through the retrieved vegetation index, it was observed that high vegetation indexes are attributed with Sentinel-2A value with respect to Landsat A throughout the time of study. From the comparison, it was found that the supervised classification from both the two sources are corresponding. Correlation was also made between the NDVI, MSI, CSI, and the leaf area index of the Landsat 8 and Sentinel 2. The results of correlation between the Landsat and the Sentinel 2A for the indices shows that the two are weakly correlated. However, the best average performance over the supervised classification was obtained using Sentinel 2 bands. The model based on Sentinel 2 data had performed Landsat 8 model for all forest variables. Results were clearly shown in Sentinel-2A supervised classification due to the fine spatial resolution of 10 meters. The study recommends the integration of data sets from satellite remote sensing centers for provide or optimized vegetation monitoring. I think that just brings us to the end. Thank you for the attention. Thank you.